Go to Psalm 78. You're there in Proverbs, just one book back. Psalm 78. Psalm 78 and look at verse number 18. Psalm 78 and verse number 18. Psalm 78, 18. Notice what he says. Notice the wording in this verse. And they tempted God. This is the children of Israel back in the wilderness. It says, and they tempted God in their hearts, notice, by asking meat. The word meat, it means food. By asking food, notice what it says, for their lust. You say, what is that a reference to? Well, if you remember, God had sent them down manna from heaven. And that manna was supernatural food that God gave them. That was all they needed. It provided all the nutrition they needed. It was all that they needed to eat for strength. But if you remember, what were they complaining about? They were complaining about the fact that they were tired of the manna. And they wanted flesh. And they wanted quail. But why in Psalm 78 are we told that they wanted? Was it because they were malnourished? Was it because the manna was not enough for them? No, the manna provided everything they needed. They were asking me for their lusts. They were asking me, not because they needed it, but just because they wanted it. And again, I'm not, you know, saying an all manna diet is something that we should do today. Obviously, that was bread that came from heaven, angels' food, you know, that was supernatural, given from God. But here we see that it is possible for people to lust. Usually when we think of the word lust, we think of a physical relationship between a man and a woman. But here the Bible says that we can lust for food. And that they were asking meat for their lust. How did God feel about this? Look down at verse 29, same chapter. Psalm 78 and verse 29, notice what he says. He says, so they did eat. God gave them what they wanted. He said, so they did eat and were well filled. And for he gave them their own, notice the word, desire, their lust. Verse 30, they were not estranged in their lust. But while their meat was yet in their mouth, while they were just stuffing their faces with this food that they were desiring for and lusting for. I just want you to notice how God feels about this. Verse 31, the wrath of God came upon them and slew the fattest of them and smote down the chosen men of Israel. That's what the Bible says. The Bible teaches here, and I just want you to understand that this is a big deal to God. God wants us to make sure that we keep our appetites, all of them, under control. Not just an appetite for fornication, not just an appetite for drunkenness and drugs, but look, an appetite, an out-of-control appetite for food. So when it comes to stewarding our health, we must learn to eat for strength. And what does that mean? Well, it means that we will control the amount of food that we eat, that we will eat what we need, not necessarily what we want.